Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 7 of the Fork Fix podcast. I am Cheri Bant, and this episode is titled Disease Reversal Hope. You need this book. I am telling you, you need this book. So today I am going to share about a book. I was going to wait until I was actually completely done with the book, and I thought about doing like a blog and talking about it, but then guys, I have to share it. It's so profound. It's so good. I want everyone out there listening, you need to check it out and you need to buy it. If you don't buy it for yourself to read, you need to buy it for someone that you love. But anyways, it's called Disease Reversal Hope. Here it is. I don't know if you can see it for anyone watching on the YouTubes, Facebook, wherever. Disease Reversal Hope. Real people, real stories. It's written by Dan Purgis and Dr. Scott Stoll. And I wanted to share about the book because the stories in it, they're amazing. They're pretty profound. They might be hard to believe them, really. But they're real. And they're about everyday people. And actually here, I'm going to read the cover. I don't know if you can see the gray there. I'm going to read just here. So you kind of get an idea. Chronic fatigue syndrome, type 2 diabetes, migraines, kidney disease, scleroderma, obesity, asthma, pain, acne, depression, infertility, constipation, anxiety, pain, irritable bowel syndrome, gallbladder disease, lupus, multiple sclerosis, high blood pressure, elevated cholesterol, PCOS, GERD, Sjögren's disease, acid reflux, arterial disease, stroke. Those are all on the cover, and there's lots more inside. I was going to read the whole list of the diseases inside, but I don't want to give the whole book away. Not that I'm going to give anything away, guys, because the stories in here are each their own, each written by the people that experience them, and just blows me away. Blows me away. For any of you who have been following along with my story, my life has been completely changed. By the things that I've done over the past 10 months, and it all started with what I was eating. And and these stories, some of them are it's amazing. It's beyond amazing. So anyways, okay, so let's just dig in. I was listening just the other day to Rip Esselstyn podcast. I actually had Tony Robbins on, and Tony shared a Confucius quote that I want to share it with you. It's a healthy man wants a thousand things. A sick man only wants one. Let me read that one more time. A healthy man wants a thousand things. A sick man only wants one. We have so much chronic illness and disease and suffering in our society today. And I know that anyone out there listening or watching this has been touched by chronic disease in some way, whether it be their own. Maybe you're suffering right now. Right now, obesity, maybe, you know, some kind of autoimmune disease, arthritis, you know, maybe you have heart disease, high cholesterol, type 2 diabetes, any of those things. Or if it isn't your own disease, it's someone I know that you have someone in your life, whether it be, you know, a friend or family, someone you love that's been touched by disease. Maybe you've lost someone to cancer or heart attack. So I know that this is something that all of us face, all of us do. But here's the thing. The stories in the book are not about another pill or procedure. It's not what we would normally think. The book's about the power of food, guys, food. And this is the thing. I'm going to get emotional. I didn't think I'd get emotional, but I'm going to get emotional. We don't think of food. We don't think to food for healing. That's just not something we think about in society. I know that in my experience with using food for healing, and I know all of you have had this as well, or I'm sure most of you have. When you were a kid or even as an adult and you get a cold, what do you have? You have soup, right? You have something warm, some soup, or you get a stomach bug, and what did your mom give you? Like saltine crackers, maybe a banana, or Sprite or 7-Up. Those were like the things we go to, the things in our society that we do. Those were like the norms, you know. To this day, I think that most people, that's, you know, a normal thing that you do. Or maybe you have something in your family like that you did when you were sick. But you understand what I'm saying. Aside from those things, we don't look at the diseases on the cover of this book and the first thing we think about is food. The first thing we generally think about is medicine or a procedure, right? So something that I have truly learned and experienced myself, especially over the last 10 months, I think it's been almost 10 months that I started eating whole food plant-based, but I realized that food can hurt, because prior to eating this way, I was afraid of food because it made me feel like shit. You know, I was afraid of what I put in my mouth because I couldn't understand why I felt so bad. And I knew it had something to do with food, but I didn't know why and I didn't understand. But I also know what I've learned is that food can heal. And my body has healed. It, you know, it's just amazing to me. Like, just for me, if you don't know my story and you're just stumbling upon this, I was pre-diabetic. I had gestational diabetes with all of my kids. I had battled with, I had gotten my A1C down a bit before it was actually probably taken. So I know that I had type 2 diabetes. But when the last time when I ended up in the hospital, because I thought I was having a heart attack, I was at the pre-diabetes stage with my A1C. I no longer am pre-diabetic. I have no diabetes. I don't have elevations in my sugar. I can eat a bowl of oatmeal or have a banana without my sugar going through the roof. But prior to doing what I'm doing now, that was a problem. I didn't eat fruit because I would have high sugars. I didn't eat oatmeal. I would have high sugars. I felt awful. Now I eat all of those things and have no problem. So I realized through the last 10 months that food can heal your body because it's healed mine. And it's healed as I'm like, for those that are listening, I'm holding up the book again. It's healed or reversed a lot of people's diseases in this book. And something else I want to share here is like when a doctor becomes a doctor, right? They take the Hippocratic Oath. I think they still do that to this day. I don't know that they take the original one that Hippocrates himself wrote. Maybe they do. I don't know. But I do know that Hippocrates wrote something else. He wrote, "Let food be thy medicine and medicine be thy food." And this is the thing. The whole food plant-based diet, the one that I've been prescribed, I was kind of prescribed from my physician, you know, he was very open when he first introduced it to me to, you know, just try eating more plants. But I'm an all or nothing person, so I jumped all in and I experienced the biggest benefit because of that. But anyways, the whole food plant-based diet is not just a diet. It's not just a diet. It's medicine. The food is medicine. So just like the food can harm us, it can heal us as well. And there's no other diet out there that can claim the healing power that's found in whole food plants. It's just not there. You're not going to find it in the Big Mac or the, you know, the McDonald's fries or a pizza. You're not going to get healed by that. Now, if you make a whole food plant-based pizza, you can. And I do have those and love them very well. But I know that eating a whole food plant, eating whole food plants in our society, like I tell you, go eat plants, right? Stop eating the proteins, the dairy, and eat whole food plants. That seems so extreme when we're in a society of Big Macs and barbecue and pizzas. But it might seem extreme, but I'm here to tell you that those side dishes that most of us, that's the way we looked at vegetables and fruit, those side dishes might be the one thing that can stop your suffering, or maybe even, or the suffering of a loved one, or maybe even heal them of what ails them. A lot of times we do not look at the food as the problem or the solution. We just don't look at food that way. And that's why I wanted to share this. I really want everyone out there who is even on the fence about, like, you've maybe listened to me talking, you're like, well, I'd like to have more plants, or maybe you're entertaining the idea, get this book. Because when it comes to, you know, let me just say this. Let me step back just a minute. I am not about, like, when I talk about healing, I realize that this is not about preventing death. Because a lot of times I think in our society too, we don't want to talk about death. Death is going to happen to every single one of us. We are going to die. You are going to die. I'm going to die. That is going to happen. That's the reality. But this is about choosing how you live now, how you're going to live in the future. Because what you're doing now to your body and the way that you're fueling it, it might take 10 or 15 years to start, like, either reaping the benefits. I mean, no, I let me just say this. You're going to reap the benefits with whole food plants right away. But if you're eating a standard American diet, what you're doing now, it's not instantaneous that you're going to, like, fall over with a heart attack because you had a Big Mac. But eating that Big Mac year after year and adding those things to your, you know, eating all the cheese and eating all the protein, the heavy protein diet, in a few years down the road, that's when you're going to see it. It may be 10 or 15 or 20 years, but it builds up in your system. And the thing is, if you want a fairly quick healing, plants are your answer. And I say that, and somebody might say, what do you mean quick healing? Well, generally within weeks, you're going to see improvement in a lot of the things that ail you. It's amazing, people. I know that I'm saying it. I am just one person, but here's a book of a whole bunch of other people that have experienced the exact same thing. So, do you want to live a life of medicine and procedures, or a life of vast energy and no pain? And it's not the end all cure all, but it's a big cure for a lot of problems. And I just think everyone needs to read the book. And that's really why I wanted to do this podcast and share. I would love to read a story to you, but I don't want to do that because you need to buy it so you can find out. But I just, there are, it's kind of astounding. There are a lot of doctors, stories in the book, doctors that were doctors and sick of disease like MS. And let's see, I don't know what some of the other ones were, but like, you know, just chronic illness, and they're doctors. So they, you know, they went to medical school, and not until they experienced whole food plant-based eating did they actually, you know, have improvement. So, but there are a lot of stories of everyday people just like you and me that have completely transformed their life with plants. And I just wanted to just like the book says, disease reversal, hope. Yeah, there's hope. And it's in the food. So for each and every one of us, we can take control of our health. It's up to us. It starts with what's at the end of our fork. And I'm telling you, food first. Like for me, the food was first, and then I had the energy, and then I could, you know, do the movement, be able to start exercising. It's just amazing. It's a whole domino effect. So once you can get, and the other thing is, this is the thing that's just so crazy, is the food that you're consuming might be the thing that's stopping you from being able to eat better. I know that sounds crazy, but with everything I've learned, the highly palatable foods, the greasy, you know, foods, the high caloric foods, it makes your body want more. So it pushes out the healthy stuff. No, most of the time you're not craving the broccoli. You get to eat like I eat, and you're like, ooh, you go down to the go through the produce aisle, and it's like pulling up at the Mickey D's for me. I honestly, I'm like, oh, look at all the fruit and vegetables. I get so excited about it now. I know that sounds insane, but my life was not like that before. Very infrequently did I visit the produce aisle. I would eat broccoli occasionally or some cauliflower. I never ate fruit. Very, very rarely did I. And now I eat tons of it. So anyways, I just wanted to share. You need to go to Amazon because that's where you can get the book. I think their website is Disease Reversal. I'm going to look in here. Maybe they don't have the website in here. But if you look up Disease Reversal Hope online, they have a website. But you can buy the book on Amazon. That's where it directs you to go anyways. So go to Amazon, get Disease Reversal Hope. If you don't want to buy it for yourself, buy it for someone you love that's maybe struggling with things. And it could be the next step to changing your life and taking control of your health. And, you know, if you're wanting to look more into whole food plant-based eating, I do have some information on the forkfix.com website. So you can hop over there as well and look at that. You can even see the latest, you know, my latest blog post there. Follow along on Facebook or the InstaFace, Instagram. I like to call it InstaFace since Facebook owns it. But anyways, follow along, and I'll just continue to sharing about whole food plant-based eating, and hopefully you'll start. And, you know, start by adding more of fresh fruits and vegetables to your plate and crowd out that other stuff. And even if you are you're on the whole food plant-based journey, get this book as well. Like if you're already eating whole food plant-based, I'm going to put it up here again, Disease Reversal Hope. Get it as well, because it will keep you inspired. It'll keep you motivated. You'll realize that, you know, it's pretty profound what you're doing, making those choices to eat those whole food plants and how you're changing your life. And in turn, guys, all that energy that you're going to gain by eating this way, it's going to affect every single person you meet. So you're not just changing your life, you're changing the people around you as well, and how they get to experience you, the whole you, not the, you know, tired version of you. So anyways, I will leave you here. So as the saying goes, how I end this, don't be screwed by food. Eat whole food, plant-based. I'll be back next week with sharing some more about plants, of course. But again, thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. Share this with someone that you know, love, you know, even the people you hate. Share it with them too. So anyways, go get that book. Hop on to Amazon. Go get it. Go get it now. All right. Have a good one. Have a blessed day. Bye now.